Thank you. Thank you. I have the pleasure to be here tonight to talk to you about what I think will be the future of skincare. The future of skincare will never be when you wake up in the morning, you look in the mirror and say, oh my God, what do I see? We have to fight aging. We really have to fight hard. Now let's come to the skin. Our skin is ill prepared to face life at a certain age. We have to assist it. Our skin is mistreated. We put too much product or no sun protection. Our skin is neglected. We say, okay, whatever happened to our skin, God meant it to be that way. No. God gave you healthy, beautiful skin. Now, that's a baby, 1 month old. Look at the skin. It's full, it's smooth, it's firm, it's even color, it's not loose, has no wrinkles, it's radiant. It's the skin you want to have.
Yeah.
And look at the apple. We just cut it from the tree. What is in common between those? This one thing is in common. Vitality. What is under the skin making the surface skin look good? It's not the wall, it's not the paint job. The beauty comes from within. I love this picture. Now, in this picture, can anybody tell me who is the mother and who is the daughter? This is my wife, this is my daughter. The difference between them, 30 years. My wife is 46, my daughter is 16. Now, I'm also maybe a good living example. I'm 66. I have no surgery, I have nothing. Now, let's talk about skin. Skin, every skin, naturally, supposed to be smooth. Supposed to be firm and tight, no wrinkles, no line, no loose skin. Supposed to be free of disease. Supposed to be strong. Your skin has to be even color. And then we have what we call the contour. When you look at your picture or a baby picture, you see fullness, fullness. But when you see hollow eyes, when you see sunken cheeks, we call that volume loss or fullness loss. Or support loss, when you start to see sunkenness, deep folds, you lost fat, you lost collagen, you lost elastin. And when you wake up in the morning, if you really want to know what's going on in your skin, all that you have to do, look in the mirror, I say, okay, is my skin smooth, firm, free of disease, strong, even color? Not dry. That's very important, not dry. So the concept of healthy skin, we define it here. You are supposed to look for healthy skin criteria. The moment you are born, to the age 10, skin is active, cells are working, everybody making collagen, elastin, keratin, even melanin, skin is smooth, skin is hydrated, you look wonderful. That's age 0 to 10. After that, I have too much sun in my life. I have sebum or oily skin. I have acne. I have scars. I have took birth control pills or I got pregnant or God knows what. My skin is damaged. I have now acne. I have sun damage. I have discoloration. I have large pores. I have rough skin. The age from 10 to 25 is called the changing age. The changing skin. Skin change. Because you are exposed to the environment, internal and external, and your habits. From age to 25, the older cells, 10 to 25, don't work in harmony. So skin change. Now, what happened after age 25? Age 30. Age 30 is the doom day. Because genetically, God programmed the skin at age 30 that all the skin's supposed to go to sleep now. They take a nap forever. Now what happened? Your skin is not making collagen anymore, not making elastin anymore, no new blood vessels, no improvement in the circulation, no ability to trap water, your skin is thinning, you will feel dry, you will feel sensitive, you will see wrinkles creeping in. You're going to say, oh my God, what did I do? Yeah. Because you can prevent all that from happening. Those cells can, we can wake them up and we can put them back to work. And we can stimulate the skin, just like exercise stimulate your body. We can tell them, come on, we need you. They will work. So, skin types, you have to know your skin type. And I'm going to teach you how to know your skin type. Skin type is so important because it will tell you what product you need, how to take care of your skin, what procedure to use, and what is best for you. Now, the first thing you have to know about your skin is one thing. Is your skin thick or thin or medium? So the best way to do it, hold the fold in your cheek. That fold. That fold. If it is 1 inch, almost 1 inch or more, your skin is thick. If that fold less than 1 inch, less than 1 inch, your skin is medium. If that fold is so thin, like a tenth of an inch, your skin is thin. Why is it so important? Thick skin. Age by falling down. You jowl. You get deep folds. You don't get wrinkles early. Wrinkles come very late. Thin skin, the other extreme. You see wrinkles creeping from around the eyes where the skin is thinner, the thinnest, creeping down. So thin skin get wrinkles early. Thick skin have a lot of collagen and elastin. Thin skin have little reserve. So medium skin get equal, jowling and wrinkling. You are not saved. So, when you know this, now you know why you look different when you are at age 60 than compared to the other lady who are at age 60. Okay? Once you know this, you will know that if you have thick skin, you need a product that tightens skin because skin gets loose. If you have thin skin, you need a product that stimulates collagen to keep your skin thick. And you have medium skin, you need both. So we want to make you feel that you have to select what your skin needs based on your skin type. The second factor is color. We have blondes on one end of the pole, and we have, let's say, African-American blacks on the other side of the pole. No color. Dark color. In between, there is a shade. Normal white, brunette, light skin, dark skin, complex skin, and so forth. The shade is important because the blondes make melanin, the dark skin make melanin. The blondes, the fair skin, their melanin is false, not real melanin. The dark have the real melanin. Because the melanin is false in the light, what they get, they never tan. They burn, they get freckles. They never tan. And because they never tan, they have the natural protection, the sun damage, damaged DNA. The dark, they don't need more tan, but they get discolorations. Many women feel that their skin is dry. Most of the products are designed to make you feel good. Notice any one of you who put a moisturizer on the face will feel good. But ask yourself one question. Did my skin need that moisturizer? What did I do by putting that moisturizer on my skin beyond feeling good? Did I do anything good to my skin? You didn't. You actually damaged your skin. See, when you put a moisturizer on your skin, just think of it this way. If you take your hands and put it in a glass of water for 15 minutes and take it out, you're supposed to see the lines gone, skin is plump and smooth and beautiful. If it's really water, is good. What you see when you take after 15 minutes, your skin is white and crinkly. Why is that? Because the surface layers have told the deeper layers, I have a lot of water there. So the body said, suck the water out of your skin. And now you're really dry. So what do you feel when you feel dry after 1 hour or two? Put the moisturizer again. It feels good. The opposite was supposed to be done. Let's wake up the skin ability to trap water from within, which you did unknowingly. You shut the door. But if I can make you feel good, it will take me 2 weeks to make you feel good. You don't wait 2 weeks because you want immediate feeling. For me to enable your skin to trap water, I need to wake up the cells, produce the sponge back again, trap the water again to make you feel good. The moisturizer you put it on is like a tranquilizer. Water and oil and protein are the three ingredients on skin surface. Your skin is made of water, oil, and protein. Moisturizers are made of water, oil, and protein. Put them on top, the surface layer that's supposed to protect you, make you feel strong, renew itself. Look what happened. The surface exfoliation stops. Dead cell stays on the skin surface. You look dull. Water balance is changed with the communication. Wow, everything I put on my skin make it burn, itch, sting, hurt. Oh, I look blotchy. Oh my God, I hate it. Now, what's happened? You altered the function of your skin. If you really want to do something with your skin, don't put anything. When the barrier function is weak and you feel sensitive, moisturizer or tranquilizers, all of you, try this. Put petroleum jelly or chipstick or lipstick on your lips. Do it for a week. You will never be able to live without it. You create an addiction of your lips to it. You want to do something better? Don't put it. Take your finger, rub your lips like this for a minute. Do that 3 times a day. You will never need chapsticks. That's called stimulating skin. By age 30, one of the right things that you have to do, you have to say, goodbye, moisturizers. And you have to say, welcome stimulators. I don't want to age faster. I don't want to make my skin weaker. I want to wake up. Your skin is a live organ. Pamper it gently, you kill it. I've been for 35 years as a dermatologist. I've treated varieties of problems. I have created a concept, what I call the healthy skin, that I talked to you about. Smooth, firm, tight, free of disease, strong, hydrated, the natural way. We talked about skin type. Now let's talk about what you should be doing. What you should be doing is simple. Remember one thing. All the cells that we talked about that are gone to sleep are not dead. We can wake them up. The moment you wake them up, they will do what they're supposed to do. They'll make collagen, they'll make a new blood vessels, they'll restore the vitality, the skin will trap water, you'll have even color tone, you'll have stronger skin, you have no sensitive skin. But this transformation from the sleepy state to waking up state doesn't happen overnight. It's gonna happen within about 2 weeks or 3 weeks. During those 2 weeks or 3 weeks, you'll feel tingling. You may feel skin flaking a little bit here and there. You may see some spot fading out. You may feel your skin doesn't feel smooth the way you used to feel when you put the moisturizer. It's like with the withdrawal from stopping smoking. You feel bad until you feel good. So that transition state is going to take place. So I want you, as a rule, before you do any procedure, make skin stronger, active, that's important. Byproducts, just simple, that make skin wake up, not to go to sleep. when your skin needs food, but the cells are sleeping, all this anti-aging product that we have on the market, Q10, edibinone, alpha lipoic acid, let's say peptide, growth factor, put them on the skin. The skin will say, I don't want them. We need to use vitamin A, active vitamin C, simple two vitamins, to wake up collagen, to make up elastin, to even the color tone, to make your skin stronger, to remove wrinkles and lack skin. You need to wake up the cells. You need to wake up the soldiers that are sleeping to protect you. You need to wake up those cells and let them go to work, to march. Now, let me show you this picture. This is my wife 20 years ago. And let's look at my wife now. My wife now is younger looking than 20 years ago. I didn't do any surgery, facelift, or anything. I just kept the skin awake. Now, vitamin A and vitamin C. You eat vitamin A, you eat vitamin C. Goes to the liver. In the liver, they are transformed into the active form called retinoic acid or retinol. This active form goes to the skin and all body organs. But the priority are, heart is a priority, brain is a priority, muscle priority, skin is not a priority. Skin receives the least amount. So we found out that in order for the skin to receive the right amount, we have to apply vitamin A active on the skin to wake up the skin. Medically, we have two types of vitamin A active. Retinoic acid, which is, you know, retin A, tretinoin, complex A, also is called the active vitamin A. When you put it on your skin, you're red, dry, and peeling. You hate it for 6 weeks, 8 weeks, 10 weeks, until the skin is repaired. That's why you need medical supervision. And that's what made me successful when I spread the word of healthy skin all over the world. That I told doctors, if the patient call you, I'm red and dry and peeling, you're gonna tell her, hallelujah, wonderful, enjoy it, you're repairing. Put it on the skin alone, as some products are available on the market. It will do nothing. Vitamin A cannot be converted in the skin to the active form. So you have to put on the skin the active form. It's either retinoic acid or retinol. Those are the active forms. If you take vitamin C, lemon, anything on the skin, it doesn't work. You have to put the active form of vitamin C. So we have created active forms of these vitamins that you can put on the skin. Simple. Once you put the active form in the skin wake up. Those forms have to be in the right concentration, in the right penetration, in the right formulation to achieve the benefit. If we're gonna talk about other retinol, which is friendly for non-medical prescription, why retinol was not been proposed in all skincare products? Because skincare products are designed to do one thing, make you feel good right away. This will not make you feel good right away. It tingles. It makes you feel dry. It makes you feel that skin is excited. You're not feeling good like when you're putting the moisturizer. Keep doing it, like the exercise. You hate the first day, you hate the second day, you hate the first week, you hate the second week. Then by the third week, oh my God, my skin now is strong. You have to give it time for the cells to wake up. Cells don't wake up like that overnight. You have to wake them up. Once your skin is strong, 6 weeks later, 4 weeks later, 2 weeks later, you got the world. So University of Michigan did a study, found out that retinol is one of the best anti-aging product available on the market. Unfortunately, it's not been used widely. It's like fairy dust. If you see product on the market with retinol, they have very weak concentration that really cannot help your skin. you really have to have the right concentration, 0.6 and up. The other thing that you need to do is you have to figure out what else I can do. The vitamin C active. Why vitamin C active is essential? Our cells are made of membrane, like a globe, like a sphere. In it is full of ingredients. At the center of the cell, there's a nucleus. The nucleus is rich with DNA. On the nucleus, there is 2 or 3 or 10 or 1 million keys. If you put retinol on the skin, retinol, think of it as the key that opened the lock. It goes to the cell. The moment it touches the receptor on the nucleus, the cell wake up and start working. Without retinol or retinoic acid, the cell's still sleeping. Vitamin C, on the other hand, protects the cell membrane. So if you're exposed to the sun, the cells resist the sun. If you have free radicals from pollution, from air, from toxin, from everything, it's gonna go attacking your cells to kill your cells, the vitamin C stops. So vitamin C is essential for your skin to protect itself. If you put vitamin C on your face, just let's say put it on the right side, not the left side, and go in the sun after 5 minutes, you'll see the side where there's no vitamin C is more red than the side that has vitamin C. Vitamin C can reduce and stabilize pigmentation problems by making the cells that make melanin produce even melanin. And don't get irritated by the sun or your hormones. So from all the product under the sun that you need vitamin A active, vitamin C active. They call the group of vitamin C active, I'm sure you heard the term, antioxidant. You can eat them. It's good for the body, absolutely wonderful for your heart, for your lung, for your brain, for your muscles. But the skin doesn't get enough. We have to put vitamin C. We have to put vitamin A active. So, when we fight aging, we showed you the benefit of active vitamin A, vitamin C. The second important thing is how to protect your skin from the sun. If moisturizers are a myth. Some screens are even a bigger one. Because in spite of all the technology of sun protection that we have today, we have skin cancer on the increase, aging on the increase, and sensitivity on the increase. You all know when you go to a department store to buy a sunscreen, you are familiar with something called the SPF, 10, 15, 20, 80, 60, 100, whatever it is. The word SPF is supposed to mean that how much longer the sunscreen can protect you, not how better. So you have to distinguish between those two things. So number 20 is supposed to protect you longer than number 10. Number 80 should protect you much longer than number 20. It's not stronger protection. Unfortunately, you sweat the sunscreen out. The sunscreen is also been rubbed off, wiped out. So most likely in 45 minutes, you will have no protection in your face. So you may have to apply sunscreen every hour for ideal protection. We want to create a safety. The high numbers that the FDA agreed that the number 30 is realistic. Anything above number 30 is giving people false sensation of safety. I put number 80 on my face, so I'm going to play all day long golf. I have protected myself. You didn't. Even the waterproof is going to give you long protection. So I created the concept as part of skin health, something called smart sun protection. Smart sun protection means What is a natural substance God giving my skin the ability to protect itself? Melanin. So I created sunscreen with the melanin in it. And then I'll give you something to block the sun effect. If it's wiped off, if it's gone down, the melanin that I left in your skin will give you longer protection. That's not enough. Yes, I give you better sunscreen, but it's not enough. What's enough is, if any one of you is sporty, when you jog, go out, play golf, play tennis, do whatever, you have to apply on your skin before, 10, 15 minutes before you leave, antioxidants. You need to stabilize. We talked about vitamin C, protect the cell membrane, give prevent inflammation. So put your vitamin C or Q10 and vitamin C or the antioxidant in your face. Then put the sunscreen. Now go out. Your skin is strong, will tolerate the sun. We give you protection, will protect you longer. Now you will enjoy a better sun exposure.